The critical investment factor is to determine the intrinsic value of a business and then paying a fair or a bargain price for it. The question is, how do you calculate the intrinsic value and how do you know what is the fair price or a bargain price for the stock? Do you want to know? Let's do the analysis, come up with a formula and understand this with the help of two examples. So let's begin. Warren Buffett simply puts intrinsic value as the discounted cash that can be taken out from the business in the remaining of its life. I like to make it a little different, like the discounted cash or earnings that can be taken out from the business for the amount of time we are invested into the company. So if we are investing it for say 3, 4, 5, 7 years, whatever is the time frame, for that much amount of time you should be paid back the total amount that you have invested in the form of earnings. That is how I like to define the intrinsic value, because Warren Buffett invests for the remaining of his life and he doesn't plan to sell. So then his definition spans for a remaining life of the business. But for us, because we are say a short-term investor, short-term in the sense that for few years, so we only calculate that many years for which the earnings of the company or the cash that the business is generating from the operations is more than enough for the price that we are paying. So that's how we define the intrinsic value. And then fair value is we apply a margin of safety, and with that margin of safety we come up with a fair price. So now once we know that intrinsic value and fair value or a bargain price for a stock, let's deep dive into the exact Excel calculations right away. I have created this Excel sheet with very few parameters that are readily available on Screener website. So we will be using Screeners and we will take the examples of two companies. So Asian Paints and Pidilite. And I will show you first how this has been calculated. So what we are using is current EPS. And I am assuming that we want to hold this stock for 10 years. So then we use current EPS. So this is the EPS in the year one. And then the expected growth rate. So based on the past growth profit growth, we calculate what is the future expected growth. What is the CAGR return that we are expecting from this investment? Generally, I prefer 25% CAGR, or 26% is a 3-year time to double, or in 10 years, it should go to 10x. So that's the expected return. Then to get a fair price or a bargain price, we have a margin of safety. And because Indian markets predominantly work on a P ratio, so what is the expected P ratio for us to sell the stock in the 10th or the 11th year? So at what price can I sell my stock? So right now I'm buying at certain price to earning ratio, and then in the future I am planning to sell it. So in the future, what is the expected P ratio? So in that year, I should be able to generate, I should be able to get the share price, the expected earnings, that EPS that it will have, and then P multiple. So then what I do is, for earnings, let's say for each year, the earnings would be, this would be same as the current EPS, and then the growth at which the company is able to grow, we keep on multiplying using the CAGR formula for 11 straight years. So from first year to 11 years is 10 years gap. And then finally, what we do is we multiply the earnings that is there into the expected EPS, and then we backtrack the share price. So what should be the share price then? And then slowly, using the same CAGR formula, we do a reverse calculation and come up with a share price that should be there currently. And then we apply a margin of safety coming up at a fair price. So let's take the Asian Paints as an example first. And in a profit and loss statement, we take the EPS as 31.59 rupees. So we apply that EPS over here. And we see that 31.59 rupees is the EPS, and at 0% growth rate, the EPS would remain the same. So now we have to put in an expected growth rate. So let's see. The profit growth has been 12, 10, 13%. So this company is growing at an average profit of around 10, 12, 13%, but sales growth is around 15%. 15%, 14% and 12% as well. So 12% would be the right estimate for this company to grow. So let's say I put in 12% over here. So now you see my EPS is growing from 1.2 other slowly but surely. So in 11th year, the EPS would be around 98 rupees. So now, and what is the expected P ratio of Asian Paints that I assume I will be able to get in the 11th year? So let's look at the chart and see what is the highest and the lowest P ratio that it has gone. So it has gone on to 120 in the last 5 years, as well as it has gone to as low as 53. So anywhere between 50 to 100 is a good estimate. So let's say we are able to sell it at say 90. So once we are planning to sell, it's not like we will be selling it at a very low P. So once the P increases, so let's say I am able to sell it at 90p. So now what happens is at 90p, 90 into 98, this is the value at which I can sell the stock. So 8830. So now what happens is if we backtrack that CAGR formula, so in the ninth year, the price should be this. So currently the price should be 948. So if you invest at 948, if the growth continues at 12%, if the return you are expecting is 25%, that means the company is growing slowly, but you are expecting much higher return. So a company is growing at 12%, but you are expecting a return of 25%. So that means the P ratio should double for you to be able to invest and give that return. But if you expect, so from 948 rupees to 8830 rupees. Now let's say if I apply a margin of safety, because I am not assuming too many things which are different. So I have expected a very low growth rate and very P ratio also I am not expecting like to be 120, 140, 180 or something like that. So then I don't need to put too much of margin of safety, only 20% margin of safety, and the fair price at which you should be investing is 758. Again, this is very low compared to the current price, but that is how we calculate the intrinsic value. Now, if we expect the growth to be in the 20% range, let's say I expect the growth to be in 20% range, then the price at which I should be able to buy an intrinsic value or fair price would be 1500 rupees. Now let's say if I expect the growth to be 30%, then the price becomes 3300, because the company is growing faster than what I am expecting. So then what happens is the PE ratio would and I am expecting the P ratio to expand as well. It's not possible for a company to keep on growing at a 30% rate for such a long time. So the fair value comes at a very, in under 750 rupees or around 750 rupees, but the stock is currently trading at around 3000 rupees. So then it's not a bargain deal. Now let's look at second example of Pidilite Industries. So let's see, Pidilite Industries, I will do a little different type of calculation. I have invested in Pidilite Industries in around 2017 time at around 700 rupees, and I'm still holding that stock. It's openly available on my blog as well. So let me just look at the EPS of 2016. So it was around 15 rupees and 66 paise. And I expected the return to be around 25% only at that time. Again, I'm expecting a 12% growth rate. I don't need too much of margin of safety. I expect to sell the company at around 100 PE as well, because we see that this stock easily trades at a PE ratio of around 100, 110 as well. and it has been constantly going up. So around 100 P is a good estimate for me to sell it currently as well. So let's look at, again, the fair value should have been 470 rupees, but I have invested at around 700 rupees, which was not too much higher than the current price. But let's say the EPS has been growing. So let's see if we have assumed the EPS growth to be correct or not, like 15.66, then 16.77. So it was not able to grow at that price. Yes, 7 is a good estimate, 16.77, then 18.95. So yes, it was around 13. Yes, little higher. Then it went to 22. So then this is where it gets interesting, like 17%. Yes, that's correct. Then again 22. So this was around 5%. No, this is around 2%. Yes, quite close. I'm not doing it exactly. Then 23.96, so this should be around 5%. So you see the fair value at which I should have bought keeps on changing, because our expected 25% CAGR return is making the EPS. But this is a back calculation again. But a company around from if we don't put this values, 470 rupees has come down to 400 rupees. It means that the 12% growth rate that we are expecting in earnings hasn't come through for the last 5-6 years. But still, if we are expecting a 25% growth rate, the price should be 470. But let's say if I lower my expectations, so 20%, so then 700 rupees is what price I should have bought it. I have bought it around the same price only. My expected, I didn't do this calculation at that time, but this is just a back calculation that I did for all my stocks. And let's do one more as well. So we duplicate this item and then let's do it for DMart. I mean, this is one of the fastest growing company. I have some investment in it. But you can see that in the past 10 years, this has grown at 38%. It has grown at 26%. And it is easily able to grow at around 25-26%. So let's say we put 23.04 rupees as the EPS. So now 23 rupees as the EPS. And I expect this company to grow at 25%. And my expected return is also 25%. I don't expect too much of margin of safety, but let's say if I put even 20% and I expect to sell this company at a P multiple of around 300, because 200 also, this company has gone to hit a 300 P and the low is 100. So let's say I expect this company, I am able to sell at 20 P. So now what happens with 20% margin of safety? My EPS keeps on growing to 214 rupees, and this share price should be 4600 rupees with 20% margin of safety from the current levels. The around 3600-3700 is what one should be investing in. Again, because we have given a very high P ratio, I have opted for 20% as margin of safety. But you can also opt for smaller companies with a margin of safety of 50%. So then at 2300 rupees, this is a good bargain buy. And if you can also expect the company to grow at a 30% rate. Again, this is getting the fair price. Now, what is the intrinsic value of a company? Now, intrinsic value of a company is the discounted cash that you can take out from this company in its due course of time. Now, intrinsic value may not be like, let's say, if in 10 years, the total amount of earnings that this company is generating. So in first year, it will generate 23 rupees. Then in second year, it will generate around 30, then 38, 50, 65, 85. So the total earnings in the 10 year is only 1297 rupees. So the earnings that it is able to generate in the next 10 years is only 1297 rupees. And total earning is not taken out from the business. So it's the cash that can be taken out. So in intrinsic value is, I mean, in 10 years, you may not get the total intrinsic value of a company out. You need a lot more time. Similar is the case with, let's say, Pidilite Industries as well. So let's say if I am the owner of this company, I am the sole owner of this company, and I am taking out the total earnings from the business, then what happens is I am only taking it out. So there is only one share and I have that share at 700 rupees. Then what happens is in the first year I make 15 rupees, in second year I make 17, in third year I make 19, 22, 24, 27, and keep on making this money. So I have in the 11th years of my holding, I have made 323 rupees. The 700 rupees that I have put in the first place, in the first year, I haven't still taken it out. And I also need to discount the rate at which I'm getting that money. So let's say if I would have put that 700 rupees into the bank account, then I would have got a lot more from the bank as well. So let's say 10%. So 70 rupees per year I would have got from the bank. So then I have to discount that over a period of time. So that is the intrinsic value of a company, and generally you will not find too many companies whose intrinsic value you can take out in a 10-year time, but over a much longer period of time you will be able to take it out. If we look at some low PE stocks, then yes, you can do that. So let me just give you an example of one more stock. It's called LT Foods. It has a 9.14 rupees as EPS. And it is also able to grow its profit at around 20%. So let's say 9 rupees is what I put in EPS. I put 20% as expected growth rate. I expect 25% as return of, and yes, I need 50% margin of safety. And this stock hasn't traded much above its, in 10 years time, it hasn't traded much above the, but I expect it to sell at around 20 PE ratio or even 30 PE ratio, because this is an FMCG company, small cap company. So let's see because I'm taking too much margin of safety, I can expect it to sell at a much higher PE ratio. So now see, 9 rupees keeps on increasing to 55 rupees, and currently it is trading at around 100 rupees. So in say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, in 7 years time, I am making 116 rupees as the total EPS. So if all the stocks, all the shares are owned by me, then I'm able to take out that 100 rupees in 7 years times. This is because a stock is trading at a low PE ratio and it is able to grow much faster. Also, you can see that at a 50% margin of safety, it is the value is at 90 rupees. The stock is currently trading at 100 rupees. So with 10% fall, it may be available at a very fair or bargain price. Again, this is not a recommendation. I'm just showing you a stock that is in an FMCG sector that is available at under 10 P. And once the stock is available at a cheaper valuation and can grow at a much higher rate, again, because it is a capital intensive business, it may not be able, you know, may not be able to sell it at 30 PE ratio. That's why we are taking a 50% margin of safety. Once you increase the margin of safety, your price at which you should be investing decreases. So and we can see that the intrinsic value of a company in 7 years time frame or in 8 years time frame, you are able to generate a return that is much more than the price what you are paying. So Warren Buffett invests in companies where intrinsic value of a company, he is able to withdraw, or the cash that the business is generating can be taken out from the business in the span of say few years. He invests for the rest of the life, but once the business is generating a lot of cash, that means the business is a good investment. And then he buys it at a very fair price or a bargain price. His investment in Apple was around 25 or 50 rupees, and currently it is trading at 150 rupees. If you apply similar formula, you will find that the Apple is able to generate a lot of cash. IBM is same, Coca-Cola is same. Do you invest with an intrinsic value and a fair price calculation? If no, this is the time you should be doing it.